speaking of trials and tribulations, you know, these things we hear from the, we read in the papers.
Right.
We hear from the press, right?
Right.
And here you are, it's a good thing you're here. Because again, if you don't want forgiveness or you don't want reconciliation,
right,
you don't even talk about it. But it's a platform for you to, because even me, I was affected by the news I heard about
right,
you.
Right.
Yes, that your wife fell ill.
Right.
She was in a dying bed,
mm-hmm,
and you abandoned her. That was the story that was spirit around.
You must know that in this life, we have a lot of enemies. God has enemies. Jesus Christ had enemies. Muhammad had enemies. Mahatma Gandhi, Martin Luther King, Nelson Mandela. So I am not exceptional.
Hmm.
And we have distractors, people who were envious, people who just feel they could be what we were because they did not know the suffering that I went through to put that together. All they wanted to do is to destroy it.
Hmm.
And so sometimes I love my children a lot. So and most of that time, all those problems, a lot of things was going, I did not want to speak because I didn't want anybody to misinterpret me to my kids. They're the most important things in my life,
hmm,
and even the life of their late mother.
Okay.
So I waited till these kids grow. And I, you know, everything that people have said, these kids have seen things by themselves. First of all, my mother-in-law Lates, in all the people that she brought and the stood together to destroy what I suffered for, you know what it is? I am the one who had to work to send Peggy to school. I was speaking on the television.
Yes, national television.
This country don't, people who talks. I have seen people sending curses to me on social media. And so I said, God forgive them because they don't know what they're doing. So all the information you heard,
mm-hmm,
about me are all lies.
Mm.
My ex-wife was sick. Do you know, while I was in America, every time I send messages, I send things, and I must send message to her. My kids have been taken care of by me while they were small, while I'm in America. So when my ex-wife was sick, I wasn't even here.
Mm.
I was in America. The mother had come to the house and destroyed our marriage and took her daughter, telling her she's going to make bigger money being alone than being a husband and wife. And I had no right, no control over somebody's child. And they felt that by doing that, ganging up, they're going to destroy me. But unfortunately, they forgot about the kids. These children means a lot. But all they think about is money to come and make, to get money, but not to be able to take care of the children that we have brought as a family.
Were they with you,
know,
or were they with her?
My kids were always, you mean when I was...
During this crisis, that phase?
No, the kids were all with me,
okay,
you know what I mean? And I did everything. I would go to my mother-in-law place to beg, and they would pour water on me. They did all kind of things to me,
mm-hmm,
to tell them, please, you know, these kids, even if you don't have nothing else, these children, the future of these kids depends on us. But they, and I told Peggy, these things you're doing, these people don't wish you well. Where were these people? Why would you listen to all these people, all these outsiders who came together with your mother? And if the father was alive still, that would not have happened. But I'm just one man. I cannot kill a Carmel all by myself. So I just leave.
Do you think she hated you that much, or she had this kind of reservations about
She her? Did not. I still feel that the mother was using all kind of, you know, diabolical things on her. I had diabolical things in my house. When I came back, things in my house. I was fighting for my life, for everything,
wow,
But I did not say nothing to anybody because I felt that is my battle. I got to fight it. I'm a man. I've seen things, you know, worse than that. But the pains that I have, yeah, you know what I mean, to have brought that girl up to that level and only to see her slip away without me being able to do anything, because everything I tried didn't work. And I didn't have to kill myself. My kids still have me right now, even though it's hurting. But, you know, let people, when they hear something, let people be careful what they say, because you're not in anybody's home. You don't know what's going on. You know what I mean? All these people that cause all these problems, a bunch of them are dead now.
Okay. Did you think there was anything you did wrongly that could also have...
It was about money. Money.
Okay.
And my mother-in-law comes to my house and asks me, how much money do you have in the bank? Yeah, if you don't tell me, I'm going to take my daughter. I'm going to do this. I'm going to do that. And because I settled the squabble between the mother and daughter, because they abandoned her, drove her away. And I had to basically take care of her at that my young age with my God's mother. And so now when this thing came, my wife swore he will never speak to the parent. I said, no, you cannot. You must talk to your parent because I stand for peace. They fought against me. They fought against us. But God has given us success. Why would you be mad at them? But keep an arm length from your mother because I know whom she was. But then she fell into whatever. And that's where the whole thing is. So when he told me that she's going to take her, I said, well, if you take your daughter, I can marry somebody else. If you think by taking her is going to make you, you know, be rich. So, you know what I mean? And that was all. People don't know.
It wasn't
anything
about womanizing or...
No, it wasn't about...
marital affairs.
Well, it wasn't about that. You know what I mean? It wasn't about that. It was not about... Nothing. It was about money, greed. You know what I mean? The only time I had to say, when they took her away, when I tried my best, and so come on now, I'm just doing most of the things because I'm kind at heart and I fear God and I try to do the right things. My life is not anybody's life.
Did that in any way informed why you left the country?
No. It was on the country issue. It was the situation,
okay,
the things, the political thing that came up in, you know what I mean? I'm not the kind of person who's going to sit around that the things we suffered for. We went on campaign with MK Abiola, and when most of these things happened in all the stuff that was going on, I would not be keeping quiet. You look at your country today, it's slipping away, and nobody says anything. Everybody and people think it's cool until one day when they wake up, they don't find a country. And this is the things that saddens me. Mm-hmm. And I'm looking at it like I have paid a price, even as a kid. Mm-hmm. My family's paid a price.
Okay.
And you're still well fighting using the music that, you know, the role music plays in building a nation. And so you got people sitting around taking our money and doing all kind of things. You got a bunch of stuff going on in the country, which don't even guarantee, you know, anything. So that was the issue, not my marital problem or anything. That cannot drive me away from my country.
Okay, when you were away, what were you doing?
I went to America. When I got to America, I got somebody who actually was kind of like looking for me until I got there. And then I got a record deal.
Hmm.
With a record company, Heartbeat Records, a subsidiary of Roundup Records, based in Massachusetts. You know what I mean? Boston, Massachusetts. So, and then that's how. And then I got that. They got me booking people. They got me management, but... You know, I start keeping onto the music because what we do, we are able to stand in a national market. You know what I mean? My people, the masses, have helped me make it here. That popularity is what made me to be able to have had record record deal in America. It wasn't, nobody knew me, but it was, what have you done in your place? And then those people that have written something about me in, you know, the papers, the magazines, and the radio had made, I mean, had some of our records there played. So it is because of Nigerians to have blessed me with their love, and that's why I was accepted somewhere else. So when I say making it in terms of the material aspect, like money that I'm using right now, and is what I made it over there right now. But without them here to have patronized me, I would not have been over there.
Now, your fans will be looking at you now, and I'd like for you to at least have one or two words to them, those who have grieved over the years. You have actually, you know, cool temper.
Right.
Personally, because I too was one of those who was holding a grudge against you over all the issues, you know, in the news at that time about you and Peggy. Now you have the opportunity, you have the platform to talk to those people who have been grieved over the years, because we loved you, we loved Mandatus. So now this is this is your chance.
I just want to say to everybody out there who might have been misinformed and because of misconception of so many people who didn't know anything, but you know, I mean, the press decide to go to town, people talk. I'm not that person that they talked about. My family means a lot to me. If I could fight on behalf of the rest people, think of what I do with my own people. Peggy was somebody that, you know, I grieved for so long. I was on tour when I was told that she passed. They had to send a message to ask me to send money so that she can be buried. And when she was sick, nobody told me. But when she died, they knew where to find me to get money to do that burial. I am sad, very sad, that which we started. As I'm sitting here now, she would have been here with me. As I'm in America, she would have been in America with me. My children are with me, my two children. And they don't have a mother. So most of these people don't know anything about me. And it's very painful. Every day I live with this. Sometimes I feel that I've not done enough. Maybe I should have gone and dragged her, but I did everything to bring her back, but it was bigger than me. There was nothing I could do. So I live with it today. And every day I see my kids, you know, it pains me. So I just want all of you to understand that, you know. And thank you for the love you give us. You give me my wife. I'm sorry.
Was a very touching one. I mean, I personally, I have forgiven you for the things you didn't do. We're just under an impression, and that's etched into our hearts because we loved you so much, and we didn't think you could do any wrong. God willing, the rest of the public, the rest of the viewers watching right now, would accept what you have fed us with, the truth of the matter, of all that actually happened. So would we're coming you back in the fold, and we know that you have something for us. Now let's tune. Let's be happy.